Dear students, before starting discussion on lattice vibrations, let's have a definition of lattice first. Lattice is an infinite regular arrangement of points in three dimensions in which every lattice point has identical surroundings. Here you can see lattice points along with bases. Please remember, bases may be a single atom or group of atoms. And when we attach bases to every lattice point identically, then we get a crystal structure. So now we can easily remember the definition of crystal structure, which is nothing but crystal structure equals lattice plus bases. Now, what is a unit cell? A unit cell is the smallest portion of a crystal lattice that shows the three-dimensional pattern of the entire crystal. It means a smallest repeating portion of a crystal lattice is called a unit cell. We have three different types of unit cell: simple cubic, body-centered cubic, and face-centered cubic. Now, in terms of solid chain, we can define now the unit cell like a unit cell is the smallest subset of chain. By repeating, we get the whole solid chain, where you can see there are masses attached to each other by elastic springs. It means atoms are coupled to each other. So lattice is a regular arrangement of atoms joined together by elastic springs. It means atoms are coupled to each other, and hence atoms shift the vibrations to next atom and so on. As far as the amplitude of vibration is concerned, please remember the condition for that, and that is force proportional to x and potential energy proportional to x square. But this condition will be only fulfilled at low temperature. As soon as we have a low temperature, condition is fulfilled, but at high temperature, large vibrations occur in the system. It means if vibration do simple harmonic motion, it means there is no thermal expansion. So, no simple harmonic motion if there is thermal expansion. Please remember first, atoms vibrate freely in their normal modes due to internal energy. This type of vibration leads to information about thermal properties like specific heat and thermal conductivity of solids. Now, in case of external forces, that forces could be mechanical or some electromagnetic. This gives rise to acoustical and optical properties of the solids. And if we incident sound waves, those are types of longitudinal waves, then atoms can vibrate along their direction. Now, in case of external forces, that forces could be mechanical or some electromagnetic forces, then in such case, we get acoustical and optical properties of the solids. And if we incident sound waves on atoms, then atoms can vibrate along the direction of propagation of waves. So sound waves can have only one mode. And if we incident electromagnetic wave, which is transverse in nature, then atoms vibrate along direction of wave propagation. So electromagnetic wave have two modes of vibration. From this way of incident wave, we get optical properties. Now we will discuss about lattice vibrations of one dimension monatomic lattice. Suppose we have one dimension monatomic chain of atoms having infinite number of atoms of mass m, which are connected by elastic spring of spring constant C. And first, they are at equilibrium, as you can see here, where if we just focus on, as a reference, on mass, this mass m at n, then after having some vibration, this mass will displace from its equilibrium position to some other point at a distance of un. By keeping the same definition and apply on other atoms, you can see, for example, this atom will move up to un minus 1, and this will move up to un plus 2. And similarly, this mass will move up to un plus 1. Now, by equation of motion, by considering the nearest neighbors, applying the Hooke's law, according to that, if f equals cx, where x is displacement from mean position of the atom and c is spring constant. This definition can be updated by having the displacement of one of the nth atom, which can be written like un plus 1 minus un for the displacement of nth atom from n plus 1th atom. And similarly, un minus un minus 1 for the displacement of nth atom from n minus 1th atom. Now the net displacement for the nth atom would be x equals un plus 1 minus 2 un plus un minus 1. Using the Newton's second law along with the Hooke's law, and the Hooke's law is f equals cx, replacing f by ma, which is equal further m second derivative of un with respect to time. Having both forces, having both definition, we can write m second derivative of un or up to second derivative equals c into un plus 1 minus 2 un plus un minus 1. Suppose this is equation number 1. Now, because atoms are performing simple harmonic motion in a chain of atoms, so displacement should be simple harmonic motion. This is the reason we are guessing the solution of the equation number 1 in terms of simple harmonic wave, which is un equals u naught e power iota into k and a minus omega t, where u naught is the amplitude of wave, omega is the frequency of vibration, and k is a wave vector. And x equals na, where n starting from 1 and a is the lattice constant, then if x equals 1a means we are talking about the first neighbor, and 2a mean the second neighbor of the nth atom, and so on. So then un plus 1 equals u naught e power iota into k into n plus 1 into a minus omega t. By simplifying this, we get here un plus 1 equals un e power iota ka. And similarly, we get for un minus 1 equals un e power minus iota ka. Now, the second equation number 1 will be updated like m second derivative of un with respect to time equals c un into this expression, which further can be written in terms of cos, and that is cos of ka minus 1. And keep the two outside of the bracket. And this expression further can be simplified like omega square equal to c over m into this term, replacing cos of ka by 1 minus 2 sine square ka over 2, we get omega square equals 4c over m sine square into ka over 2. Suppose this is equation number 2 now, which further can be written like omega equals 4c over m under root modulus sine of ka over 2. Equation number 3. This equation number 3 is nothing but the frequency dispersion relation for monoatomic lattice. Means this is the relation between omega and k. So this is further can be now we want to plot, and but please keep information about the modulus that we have the modulus here, the reason omega can't be negative. Let's find the c from the previous equation. Suppose if we have omega equal a sine of ka over 2, then comparing this equation with the equation number 3, we get a equal 4c over m under root. This a, as I have written in the previous slide, like u naught. So a is nothing but u naught. So please keep that in your mind. So doing these steps, we get c equal ma square over 4. To interpret the equation number 3, let's take a case 1 where we have a long wavelength. It means k tends to 0. So by replacing sine of k over 2 by k a over 2 in equation number 3, we get omega equals 2 into c over m under root k a over 2, where you can see a clear linear relation between omega and k. Now, what is phase velocity? That is omega over k equals c over m under root a, which is further equals vs. Vs is nothing but sound velocity. I'll talk about the sound velocity in the next few slides. Now, what is group velocity? Group velocity equals derivative of omega with respect to k equals C over M under root A, which is also equals Vs. Now, if you look at the result, we get the V phase equals V group velocity and further equals sound velocity. So it means at low frequency or at long wavelength, medium is non-dispersive. It means that it can be considered as continuous and homogeneous medium. And this is also known as a continuum model. In this model, speed velocity is independent of k. Let's talk about sound velocity now. If Vs is the sound velocity in the solid, and S equals CA, where S is S in longitudinal, is nothing but longitudinal stiffness. Stiffness means how hard or gentle spring can be. And rho density equals M over A, which is mass density. So by having both rho and S, we get Vs equals S over rho under root equals A into C over M under root, which is exactly the definition of the phase velocity and the group velocity, which you can see on this slide, where we have the phase velocity equals this term, and group velocity is also equals the same term. Okay. Now, let's take the second case, where we are taking now the short wavelength or high frequency. Because there is no approximation on k, in this case, we have simply omega equals 4c over m under root sine of k over 2. And by the definition of phase velocity, that is equals omega over k equals 1 over k into this term. And the group velocity would be the derivative of omega with respect to k, and we will get this term. You can see now, in the case 2, we get different results for phase velocity and group velocity. So it means phase velocity is not equal to group velocity in this case. So medium is dispersive. Okay. Suppose we have a zero group velocity. In that case, this term will go to zero. And further, zero can be written like cos of plus minus pi half. By this expression, simply we get k equals plus minus pi over a. This shows the boundaries of first Brillouin zone. It means that at Brillouin zone boundaries, group velocity would be zero. This is very nice result. I will show the result in the graph in next few slides. And now you can see omega versus k graph becomes a omega versus k graph becomes a flat. Please note, whenever we have k equals plus minus pi or a, then simply that can be further written like 2 pi or lambda. That gives us result lambda equals 2 a. So it means that if wave has a wavelength of 2 a, then its group velocity will be equal to zero. So please note that at plus minus pi or a, the wave can't carry any energy, and hence we will get standing wave instead of traveling wave. Now finally, we have dispersion curve between omega and k, which is periodic in nature with a period of 2 pi and symmetric about k equals zero. This curve shows mirror symmetry. Omega function of k equals omega function of minus k. This mirror symmetry implies that plus k minus k actually representing the plane wave propagating in the positive direction and negative direction through the monoatomic lattice. For case 1, at low frequency, omega versus k are linear to each other. This red line showing on both sides indicating the linear behavior among omega versus k. In this case, group velocity equals to phase velocity, which further equals to sound velocity. Hence, medium in that case is non-dispersive. It means it can be considered as continuous and homogeneous medium. At high frequency, graph is curve-shaped and it becomes flat once it reaches to top of the band. Group velocity is not equal to phase velocity at high frequencies, hence medium is dispersive. At value of plus minus pi over a, which are the boundaries of the first Brillouin zone, where the group velocity is zero. Please remember, as for the wave is in the frequency band, wave propagates like a traveling wave, but it becomes a standing wave at the boundaries where group velocity is zero and where the frequency is maximum, and that equals to 4c over m under root. At boundaries, wave can't transmit to the medium, and Bragg's condition is satisfied by the wave.